What's up guys, welcome back for the Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video. Next match, Cross Balanced Cup. First match here in the top 4. Both of these decks still haven't lost a match, right? So again, they can still afford like losing one and they'll just move on to the left side of the bracket. But again, two title candidates are paired up against each other. Let's take a look. First of all, you have Pendulum Magicians from 2017. Both deck lists are from 2017, by the way. So from the same year, not really sure if they're from the same format, probably. Both these decks, you know, like pre-Master Rule 4. So yeah, pretty much 2017, so very close to pretty much the same format. Anyway, so Pendulum Magicians, Pre-Master Rule 4, Astrograph Sorcerer, having the double Iris Magician is just a ridiculous card. Banned for a good reason. Second list, Uhuru King, Dinosaur Yangzing. I think this should be an OCG list, not really sure about that, but it's still nonetheless a very strong list, with the Danglong, of course, and the full, basically the full True King engine as well. So which deck has the advantage? It's quite difficult. Going first is of course quite important, especially in case of Pendulum Magicians, and because I'm looking at their extra deck being Dweller. Dweller is of course very important, a very important card against something like True King Dinosaurs, right? So Yangzing as well, but mainly going first, putting up Abyss Dweller is definitely in the advantage of Pendulum Magicians. And people prefer True King Dinosaur Yangzing a little over Pendulum Magicians. For me, that's quite interesting. Personally, I saw that, or I felt that Pendulum Magicians would have the slight advantage over True King Dinosaur Yangzing. Mexi again for the extra draws and basically end the opponent's turn here. In case of True King Dinosaur Yangzing, it's hard to you know, like go through Mexi, or you know, give your opponent as less draws as possible, and well, put up multiple negation in the process as well. For True King, that's not possible. So as you saw, yeah, as we know from previous match, Mexi was quite important, and That's how it was when Mexi was legal for us TCG players, how much of an impact it had on the, yeah, on the format, on decks, on plays. It's just a super crucial card, and okay, there might be some reason that maybe for future editions, cards like Emptiness and or Mexi should maybe be banned, but you know, like there's like that small voice in the back of my mind saying that, well, these cards were legal during their prime, during their period, and they all definitely had like a huge impact on their on their format. So, I mean, it's food for thought. Anywho, so Pendulum Magicians, thanks to the Mexi, prevented the True King Dinosaur Yangzing from setting up, having those multiple negations with Pillars, with Herald as well, and Interruptions with the potential, well, Trishla into, let's say, the True King of all Calamities, and Conductor as well. So those were definitely all options, I believe, if it wasn't the case for Mexi. So game number 2, no hand traps this time, but I do get Trish, then that's a problem. Oh my god. The thing is that if True King Dinosaur Yangzing is able to open with Instant Fusion as well, that's so ridiculous. They can go for Librarian first and get a couple of draws in the process. Next to Trishla, you know, like the good stuff for the deck. And Conductor Tyranno didn't really matter too much because of True King of All Calamities preventing attacks and monster effects, I guess, in general. So, yeah, whatever, what can I do? Another Danglong hitting the scene, searching the Pot of Avarice? Yangzing Path, I believe. And yeah, Baxia, I believe the name is, bouncing back a couple of cards, and eventually, you know, Conductor will just clear the board, and the other cards will just eventually attack for game. So, again, a very explosive first turn, and the thing is that, and that's the cool thing about this matchup, is that both these decks have access to Ash Blossom, and as we have seen in the past, is that having access to Ash Blossom is of course quite crucial. So again, okay, both these decks, I'm not really sure, I think they're both main decking the maximum amount of Ash Blossoms. Again, correct me if I'm wrong. Anywho, so Ash Blossom again, quite important, going first here, the one of Ash Blossom preventing the search for the continuous Pendulum Grav spell. That's fine, but I can still recover thanks to Astrograph Sorcerer, and I have a couple of options, but I think going for the first turn Dweller was so crucial. And of course, yeah, Tornado Dragon giving me the extra search, the trap card search, and in some cases, the Tornado Dragon might be good against True King Dinosaur Yangzing to, you know, prevent the Nine Pillars from being set. I guess if that makes sense, are being destroyed during the end phase, and of course the True King field spell diagram. So that's cool, especially with the protection of the trap cards. But yeah, some interruptions, and now again, Pendulum Magicians, Master Rule 3 is just ridiculous. The Pendulum mechanic is just ridiculous during Master Rule 3. Dimension Fusion once per turn, and you know, it's like screaming advantage at the same time. Multiple beat sticks to attack for a game. So game number 4, True King starts off, and that's definitely an okay start, but I think I have to Ash Blossom here, the diagram, prevent the level 4 dinosaur from coming out, and you know, that dinosaur being the Oviraptor, but ready at the Oviraptor in hand, so that's cool. It's fine, okay, Danglong comes out, and the problem here is that, okay, definitely one negation being the 9 pillars, but there is the potential chance that Danglong can turn itself into a level 3, and of course, level 1 tuner, Chiwen, I believe the name is, will special summon itself at the potential level 4. Synchro being Herald, and Herald, you know, like the macrocosmos effect, plus the fact that it can, it's basically a Solemn Judgment on legs. Anywho, the level level 3 in hand, so there wasn't the option to go for the Herald ride, but in the long run, again, it's not going to matter too much, okay, even though Miscellaneous Source only protects during main phase, so I do opt to use a trap card to get rid of the field spell and Conductor as well, but there are so many options left, especially with the Oviraptor on field effect to trigger the small dinosaurs, and again, Yazzie, etc., the Conductor as well, Path to reset up your Danglong engine, your Yangzing engine. It's like, whatever. What can I do? So the also important game number 5, and that's where Pendulum Magicians should have the advantage again in theory of opening with the Dweller if it's not for a break. I'm like, oh, well, what's this? Again, it's like a recovery play. Just normal summon your Black Fang, put Poison Violet Magician in the scales, and okay, Maxi is cool getting the extra draws, but again, I kind of have to hope that, well, True King also breaks, like normal summon Oviraptor. Then I can just, let's say, Ash Blossom that if there is not like a Miscellaneous Source active, but nope, that's not the case. Double Diagram, that's ridiculous. Okay, I do have like a lot of draws here, going plus 10 or whatever, but it's not going to matter since there is the option to go for Baxia, not really sure, but Trishla is definitely an option to get rid or prevent the Poison Violet Magician from triggering, and even then, or yeah, pretty much keep me in the duel. So even then, didn't really matter too much, and this is definitely more than enough to attack for a game. So, a small break here during the last duel definitely cost Pendulum Magicians the duel. The match in general. So, yeah, it feels a bit bitter in the long run. But do we have a deserved winner? I feel so. Even though, you know, like Maxi, True King, at least, yeah, True King Dinosaur Yangzing got Maxi during the first duel, if I'm not mistaken. So, I think again we have a well-deserved winner. An extra duel just, you know, like, prevent spoilers going first, and why didn't I have this hand in the previous duel? This is, I think, the best hand you can have. You have the Pendulum Graph spell to get an extra, well, best hand. Even after the Ash Blossom, I can recover and put out a Dweller. Even though Dweller might get destroyed, will probably be destroyed during the opponent's turn. It's just enough to prevent Dinosaur Yangzing True King to set up and potentially go for a game. Pendulums having the extra turn definitely helps out. So keeping this scales alive and getting rid of Oviraptor, not that important, but just more important is the getting a surge during the damage step here, since again that was important because of the Ash Blossom in hand, as we see now. Going for Omega, and Omega should pretty much seal the deal, prevent Oviraptor from searching Conductor as well. So yeah, now I can just go for game, getting a huge Pendulum Summon off with Harmonizing Magician as well, setting up a couple of Exceed plays, should be going for Trapeze Magician probably as well. Ignisser is definitely good also, getting another Surge in the process, and dropping another Astrograph Sorcerer as well. So, okay, it's cool. Pendulum Magicians is still in the tournament, and they'll move on to the left side of the bracket, preventing, you know, like, matches we have put it on the bottom. Next matchup, this potential opponent for Pendulum Magicians is either Monarch, Extra Deck Monarchs, or Atlanteans. Anywho, next matchup, you're on the right side. The other top 4 match, we have ABC's ABC.deck versus Zodiac. So again, like always, feel free to leave your predictions which deck is going to win this particular matchup. ABCs versus Zodiacs. And then we'll know our small finals, I guess. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. League Them signing out. Peace.